Amen. But for a subtopic I want to bring to you tonight, prepare for battle, wage war, the fight is on. I got 3 points for you. Number one, we have to come to the mindset that this is a spiritual fight and not a physical or natural one. Ephesians 6 and 12 says, "For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and spiritual wickedness in high places." 2 Corinthians 10 and 3 through 6 says, "For we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but are mighty through God for the pulling down of strongholds." Say amen. Number two, it is time to suit up. Stop coming before the enemy or against the devil unprepared with no protection. Half-dressed Christians. God said it's time for us to put on the whole armor of God. Ephesians the 6th chapter, 13th through the 16th. "Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, stand. Parts of the armor, your loins girt about with truth, having on the breastplate of righteousness, your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, with it ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the devil." See, when we're not fully dressed, the devil begins to throw stuff at us. That's why we fall down by the wayside. But God said it's time to suit up. If Christ be for us, in us, and with us, who can be against us? Number three, it's time to wage war. Now that our mind and our spirit has been renewed, it's time that we go head on and fight against the devil. Matthew 11 and 12 says, "And from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffereth violence, and the violent take it by force." What you want back from God, you got to get it. What you want back from the devil, you got to take it. He didn't take it nicely from you, so don't be nice to the devil. Jude 1 and 3 says, "Exhorts to us," and it says, "Contend for the faith that was once delivered to the saints." It's time to take arms, to stand up for holiness. God ain't looking for no coward soldier. He ain't looking for nobody to be walking slew footed. He said, "I've called you by my name. You are mine, so walk holy." Number three, the fight is on. But God can't use it just anybody. He told Joshua, "Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with thee, wheresoever thou go." He ain't going to send you to the battlefield alone, but he'll be by your side the whole way. If Christ is for us, in us, and with us, who can be against us? When the enemy comes in like a flood, God said, "I will raise up a standard. The glory belongs to God. He will deliver." Psalms 23, verses 7 through 8 says, "Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up, everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in." Who is the King of glory? Oh, the Lord strong in battle. If Christ is for us, if he's in us, if he's with us, he's more than the whole world against us. Prepare for battle. Wage war. The fight is on. If Christ is in us and with us and for us, we are more than conquerors through Jesus Christ. We got the Holy Ghost living on the inside. We got the strength of God living on the inside. We don't walk not like we weak, but we should walk and steadfast and strong in the Spirit. God don't work in numbers, but he works in those who are willing. In a battle with Gideon, he had 3,000 soldiers, but those who were waiting and preparing, yet with their eyes focused on the enemy, but still giving God the prayer. God said, "I want the 300 that laugh like dogs." So he said, "Come unto me, all ye labor and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon me, learn of me, and my yoke is easy, and my burden is light." Wage war, but fear for battle, the fight is on.